goddamn spot. Out I say. One.
Let's see what to do today. Steinway Grand Piano for sale to connoisseurs. Phone 555-1264. Yeah, that'll do. Sorry to disturb you, ma'am. Are you offering a piano for sale?
Yes, I am. The Steinway Grand.
Cross-stringed?
Cross-stringed, English action.
What condition is it?
Oh, it's in excellent condition, I'm very glad to say. Oh, it's an absolutely pure tone. It's really a very top-quality instrument.
A Steinway Grand.
Yes, it's a Steinway Grand. I've just had it tuned.
And what price are you asking for it?
$10,000. Would you be interested?
Sorry, did you say 10,000?
Well, as I said, it's an excellent instrument.
$10,000? Well, I must say that the price seems a little steep.
Now listen, I've had an expert in to value it. He said that a connoisseur would pay even more for it. If you really are interested, then perhaps you can come here and have a look at the piano yourself.
No, I'm sorry. I'm afraid that price is just too much for me. $10,000. What a ripoff. You'll come down a notch or two yet, my dear.
Hello?
Good afternoon. This is Lieutenant Commander Gruber speaking. Is this 555-2364?
Yes, Commander. What may I do for you?
Oh, thank you for the promotion, ma'am. But it's Lieutenant Commander. The thing is, I'm looking for a piano for me little daughter. A solid instrument that the child can practice on. You see, I'm having her taught the piano.
This is a Steinway Grand. It's, an English action. It's a perfect cross-stringed instrument.
Oh, she's been learning for 4 years. And so far we've only rented a piano, and a not too good one. But she's making such good progress that my wife and I thought that, what with her birthday coming up, if we could find her a piano that would match her in every respect.
Oh, I'm sure that this would be just the thing for your daughter. Well, it's in excellent condition, and I just had it tuned a few days ago.
Aye, and when can I look at the instrument?
Oh, any time you like. I'm always at home.
Believe me, the girl's playing's a miracle. Really, just a miracle. It makes no difference to her whether she's playing a Beethoven or a folk song or Chopin or even anything from the Beatles. No, 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 no. Na 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 na, ding ding.
Well, when will you be coming to see the instrument?
Oh, tomorrow morning be all right for you. Let's say 11:30. By the way, what's the price of the piano?
It's $10,000.
Ah, you said 4,000?
What an idea. I said 10,000.
$10,000? You aren't really serious, ma'am, are you?
As I said before, Commander, this is a top-quality instrument. It's a Steinway Grand with English action.
Do you know what the price of a normal piano is?
You know, Commander, pianos are as different from each other as chalk from cheesecake. Well, perhaps for the time being, an upright or else a less expensive piano might do for your daughter.
How can you ask for $10,000 for a second-hand piece?
I've told you already. It is a genuine Steinway Grand. It's an instrument of very superior quality.
Are you aware of the fact that, according to paragraph 823 of the Penal Code, usury is a criminal act? It's incurring the punishment and criminal offences.
But, Commander, please.
Not bad. Not bad. Now for some emotional work on the cellar.
Is it you who's selling the piano? I'll get Granny.
Who's speaking?
Oh, it's Bobby. Oh, Granny. No, don't get out of bed. No. I'll bring the phone over. Okay, here's Granny. Bye-bye.
Hello? Is this
Steinway Grand still for sale?
Well, yes, it is, but it's... only for serious connoisseurs, because...
Oh, my dear, I'm a serious buyer. And the matter is extremely pressing. I mean, if we could settle the terms. As I understand you, you haven't sold the piano yet.
Is this really so urgent for you?
It's terribly urgent. Not for me, but... for my daughter. I would be buying it for her.
Granny, I want some peanut butter and jelly bread.
Shut up, Bobby.
But Granny, I want some PBJ bread.
Just go along, Bobby. Go on playing and I'll get your PBJ bread for you afterwards. I'm sorry, my dear, that was my little grandson. So, back to the piano. You know, this is a tradition in our family. I have four daughters and each got a piano for her wedding night, except the youngest one. She's the black sheep in the family, and...
Granny, I want my bread!
Keep quiet, Bobby. You see, I even have to look after her child.
Well, you might thank heaven for having a family. I'm old, and I'm sick, and I've nobody with me. I'm left quite alone. Well, as I understand, you made up your mind and you want to surprise your youngest daughter with the piano?
Yes, she is our daughter anyway. Let me ask you, how much are you asking for the piano?
I thought $10,000.
$10,000.
Granny? Granny? Granny?
Well, that's an effective piece of work. Now, let me think. What should come up to spice it up a little bit more? A high-sounding name. See, Williams. Wilford Wilson. Willoughby. Yes. Yes, that'll do. Willoughby the connoisseur.
Hello. Is that 555-2364? Were you offering a piano for sale? Hello? Hello? Can't you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Were you offering a piano for sale?
I'm sorry, but could you ring me up a bit later? I don't feel too well just right now.
Oh, I got your number from the Times Colonist. It says 555-2364, the piano. Is that right?
It is. Yes, it is. But...
This is Willoughby speaking. Aristotle Willoughby. Don't tell me you've never heard the name.
I'm sorry, do we know each other?
Strange. I am generally used to being known. I mean, in the trade.
In what trade is that, if I may ask?
The piano trade, of course. Wasn't it a piano you were advertising? You must have heard the name before. Ask anybody who... The leading man in the trade is, for 28 years, grand and upright pianos, Call Willoughby.
I can well believe it, but I've had many inquiries.
Madam, there are always many people inquiring, but there is only one Willoughby. And when Willoughby puts his hand to the plough,
I don't know what to say. If I had only known how nerve-wracking and exasperating this whole affair was going to be, I would have never put the advertisement in the paper.
Why? Aren't you the owner of the piano?
I most certainly am, and I have been ever since I was a young girl. You know, I'm a lonely old widow, and I've been living alone by myself for many, many years, and it's just this piano is standing here and nobody's playing it.
You don't play, madam?
Oh, well, I used to play in the old days, and, well, people said that I wasn't too bad, but, well, since my poor son died in Afghanistan, I haven't opened it for 8 years, and I just really didn't feel like it. Well, my husband never stopped wearing a black tie, and for my son, and now, well, he's in his grave. Who should I play for?
Forgive me, madam, but I think music is the purest and most exalted of pleasures. Ah, comfort in sorrow, and most particularly so if we make music for our own delight.
Am I to understand that you want the piano for yourself?
No, madam, although I do play myself. But it is for a client of mine, a most distinguished and serious buyer, who wants an instrument of unquestionable quality.
Oh, this is a cross-string Steinway Grand. It's English action, and it's in excellent condition. It was tuned just recently.
And its appearance? Is it a decorative piece?
Yes, it has a very fine, old-time luxury finish. It's nut brown.
And what sort of price were you thinking of?
Please, I'm not going to mention any price on the telephone. If you really are interested, well, if you're interested in the instrument, then please, could you just come here and we could continue to talk personally. I do hope to see you soon.
Yes, but I would like to come with the buyer. I repeat, he is a very serious and distinguished gentleman who has absolute confidence in my discretion. So, the least thing I must be able to tell him is the price that we can expect.
I will tell you as soon as you're here.
My dear lady, how do you think I can take him there without even knowing so much as a price? You surely don't want to ruin my reputation, do you? At least, tell me a guiding price that might serve as a starting point.
I'm sorry, there will be no starting point, and there will be no bargaining. I'm not a rag-and-bone merchant. $8,000.
You said 8,000?
Why? Do you think that that's too much? Well, for a genuine Steinway Grand?
On the contrary.
How do you mean on the contrary?
Well, I was just thinking that if this piano is really in as excellent a condition as you say it is, then we may as well get more for it. Why should you throw such a serious asset away?
I don't quite understand you. You would be willing to pay more than I ask?
Not me, madam, but the buyer. Let's go 50-50 on anything above $8,000. It's good business for you as well as for me. And it's also a good bargain for my client, since he is going to get a top quality instrument for his money.
How much do you think?
Well, perhaps 10,000. We shall settle the accounts afterwards anyway. If I find my customer, it might even be this evening.
Well, I shall be at home.
Good. Then I shall get in contact with my client right away. By the way, I haven't asked yet, what the tone is like?
Oh, it has a clear, strong tone, and it's quite an easy touch.
I certainly wouldn't like to inconvenience you, madam, but for the sake of the transaction, I don't know if the piano is near enough to the telephone, and maybe you would do me the favor of striking a few notes? It makes a difference, even if I heard it only once. It's simply fantastic. Oh, just play something more, please.
I haven't played for ages. fingers will get lost on this keyboard. It's no good anymore.
Oh, it's really very nice. Please, don't stop playing.
I'm out of practice. It's terrible, isn't it?
How can you say that? It's a great pity you don't play with your musical feeling. You have genuine artistic talent.
I won't study for 10 years. I was expected to go on to the conservatory. Would you believe that when I was a young girl, well, we had a concert every Thursday, and my youngest sister played chamber music, and we always had a lot of people there. Well, we had tea, we talked about art, we talked about literature. A piano for my 20th birthday. Oh, I can't tell you how happy I was.
If I am not being too tactless, may I ask why you've decided to sell it?
I couldn't even afford as much as a headstone for my husband and for his grave. I certainly don't feel like playing. I don't feel like playing the piano, especially, I don't know what I, well, I'm lying in bed most of the time.
But I hope it's nothing serious.
It's my heart, it's, it's valvular deficiency, the doctor said.
Oh, if you just look after yourself, you may yet live to be 120.
Very rarely. You know, my neighbors are very kind. Well, they do the shopping, they do what they can for me. I have a woman in twice a week to clean.
See, madam, you really need that money for the piano. Maybe I'll dash out right away to fetch the buyer. I'll call you soon, madam. Goodbye.
So, that was nicely done. Disgusting weather. Perfectly disgraceful. Been raining for weeks. Well, what else can we squeeze out of this? We need a dramatic twist somehow. Need some excitement here. Maybe a thriller.
Hmm. Hello? Is this 555-2364? This is Dr. Goldberg talking from the Dunsmuir Memorial Sanatorium. Forgive me, madam, for intruding, but we have an issue here.
What may I do for you? Is this about the piano?
No, I mean, yes. It's such an unpleasant thing. I really don't know how to put it.
What is this all about?
Excuse me, but haven't you been called just now by a gentleman named Willoughby?
Why do you ask?
Because he is one of my patients, and he thinks he is a piano salesman. I was just called away to a serious case, so I left him alone in the nurse room for about 10 minutes. Now I am back, and I found my newspaper with an advertisement about a piano marked in red pencil. I have no doubt it was him. Did he talk to you?
What if he did?
Oh, don't worry, madam. He is not too dangerous. He just acts like a serious businessman. I don't know what you were talking about. I guess he offered you a deal on your piano.
Well, yes, but he sounded like a real gentleman.
He is a really sick man, madam. We just finished a neurological treatment on him. He was on a sleep cure for 4 weeks. Typical case. Sometimes he acts just like a normal person, like you and me. Only, he gets mad and offensive if he does not get what he wants. Ooh.
I must say that I'm absolutely shocked.
Oh, here we are. He's just coming. Ah, Aristotle, you are here. You promised me a million times not to call unsuspicious advertisers who sell pianos. You are not a piano salesman, and you cannot pretend to buy pianos. Do you understand? Wait. No. What is that you have there? Aristotle? Is that a scalpel? What? Aristotle! Aristotle! No! 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 Ah! 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 Ah!
Hello? Madam? Hello? She hung up. Hello? Hope nothing's the matter. Why don't you answer? Lift the receiver, please. It was the right number, right? Damn it. Why are you doing this? Valvular deficiency, she said. She said valvular deficiency, didn't she? Come on, nothing can happen from just a silly little phone call. It's just a joke. I mean, pick up the phone! All right, I'm gonna give you 3 more rings, all right? 1, 2, 3. Suppose I haven't broken it now. It's
Hello?
God, at last! Why didn't you answer?
Who's there?
There isn't anything wrong with you. Is there? You're okay, right?
Who is this speaking?
It's me again. Don't you recognize me? You've just spoken with me. And earlier, too. It was all me.
Who, the doctor?
No. No, madam, I'm no doctor. You see, this is my hobby. Just the same as golf or ice hockey or fishing or darts, you know, and sports, you know, love. Just, is there hobbies for others? I get home at 6 in the evening, and then I begin to phone. My hobby isn't even expensive. I just pick an advertisement randomly from the daily newspaper.
And upon the inspiration of the moment, I was all you were talking with in the last half hour.
This has really gone too far. I won't stand for such unpleasant jokes. How dare you?
Madam, all I want is to apologize. I know you're very angry with me. Maybe you even hate me. You're right. I've thought it over, and it would be difficult to find any excuse. You're right. It was a bad joke. A foolish joke. I am a telephone gangster. A telephone hyena. I'm ashamed. And all I want to ask you is just, well, put yourself in my shoes, just for a moment. I want to appeal to you as a wrongdoer appeals to the righteous. And, you know, someone who forgives those who trespass against them.
Why, are you ill?
No. Not physically, at least, but just imagine. I come home from the library where I work, and it is sheer drudgery every day from 8 to 5, and then I come home to this empty, eternally empty room. That makes 15 hours till the next morning. 90 hours a week. 360 hours a month.
Aren't you ashamed of passing the time with such nonsense? Haven't you a family or relatives?
Well, I lost my mother when I was still young, and I never knew my father. My foster parents died as well, just after I got married. And that marriage didn't last too long either. Officially, I'm divorced. But I would rather say I am rejected. There was a time when I thought that loneliness was an extraordinary condition, like tuberculosis. One can be cured of that. Then I slowly realized that this is the natural form of life. Everything else is just self-deception. The real community, the largest on the globe, is 3 billion loneliness. Didn't you ever think about how the more people there are in the world, the less they understand each other? 3 billion astronauts, all by themselves, drifting in space.
Well, I also live alone, but even so, I don't talk like this. Because not 1 hour passes, not even a minute, but I didn't feel the presence of God. You're not even old, are you?
I am at the worst age. 30.
Young man, you might remarry, perhaps.
I lie here every night. Always the same senseless, pointless brain gymnastics. So many years I've been living in a morbid state of weightlessness, where the attraction of gravitation doesn't act on me at all. I know it's a dull story, but the lives I invent on the telephone are so much more real.
Well, it can't be too easy for you either, but look, I suffer from heart trouble, so let's just ring off, shall we?
No, please. No, don't hang up. It's nice talking to you. You're so calming. We even could be friends. You know what? I don't want to be intrusive, but it would be really lovely to see you. I can imagine your apartment with its fine old furniture with lace and cushions and the ornaments, the big wardrobe, family photos on the wall, the piano covered with a fringed cloth, and a bust of Beethoven above it. Or is it Wagner? Or Schubert? And the music stand next to it. We'd have tea together. You've certainly got fine old China service with yellow and brown leaves. I'd bring you chocolates. And then we'd talk about Stravinsky or Bartok, and I'd tell you the latest gossip about town, and what cruise ships are passing along the coast, and what's in the shops, and so on. And you'd play for me. You could be like mother to me. And I could be somebody like your lost son. You aren't cross anymore, surely. I know, I feel you have forgiven me. You've understood me and pardoned me. Are you still there? Oh, okay, I'll stop now, I promise. I won't bother you anymore if you don't want. But if you think that you could forgive me, I think we could be friends. Beacons for each other in the midst of loneliness. Please call me back. My number's 544-1213. I'll be waiting for your call. Bye now, madam.